Yes!
Sorry, Skype is being...
Okay, hold on one second. Let me make sure that you are not too quiet or too loud. Give me one second. Let's do some tests. Okay, talk.
Hello. My name is Kelly.
I think that's fine.
Okay.
If the stream has a problem, they'll let me know. Okay, Miss Kelly, I don't know what you've been...
A subscriber? What are you, gay?
Velocity just said, thank you so much.
Hey, bitch.
I was looking at my HTC phone, and I noticed that people were saying, she won't at you, though. She won't at you, though.
Yeah, I saw that.
And I thought that was the funniest shit, and so I was like, okay, well, then, yeah, she won't at me, though. She ain't gonna at me, though. And then you added me, though.
No, I definitely have balls. Definitely don't have a problem with that. I just don't feel the necessity, like, the need to do that always if I don't think that my opinion is gonna change the opinion of somebody else's.
And I think that neither of us are going to change our opinions, but at the very least, you know, we can make this fun, enjoyable, and easy, much like Vulcan.com, very easy to use and user-friendly. This discussion should be safe, like Kurt's voice. Now, let's start. Why don't you tell me, what problem did you have with my video?
Well, I picked out a few bits specifically. I can just reread what I wrote.
Sure.
I don't think that women who have cleavage are the problem or the part that is making it hard for women. In fact, I don't even think it's the thirsty males that are the problem. It's the ones that go around harassing women that are the problem. There's a difference between guys who are being, you know, a little bit creepy, and then there's guys that are... In fact, it's worse when they come around to your stream and try to tell you that you're breaking rules that you're not breaking, or as I had today, about a billion people post your video in my stream. That was
Jesus.
Fun. Yeah, thanks.
Well, I want to clarify something, and I think this is a message that maybe I didn't convey well enough or was just missed. But my message is not, if a girl has breasts, she's hurting the female community. No, look, people are born. Some women are born hot. Some women are born ugly. Some men are born hot, and men like me are born ugly. It's just the cards that were dealt. God sometimes is just drunk when he makes people, and some people just don't get the right jawline or the right look or whatever. And I believe that if a girl is looking cute, you know, she got some big titties and she wants to show it, then she can show it. That's absolutely fine, and I have no problem with that at all. In fact, I respect the hustle. I do. If you are going to use that method, because in the Twitch game right now, it's just being a girl in the Twitch game is difficult. And that all stems from, like, how women are portrayed in the media. It's just a hard world for women, and some of these women are just playing the game as the cards they were dealt, and I understand that. That is great. I have nothing against that. And it's, in fact, I respect it. People like Nicole Slaw, whoever's going to do it, I respect it. Do you, boo-boo. But I just feel like, for starters, I feel like when you do those things and you are taking advantage of the already fucked system of how women are portrayed or how women can be sex symbols, I just feel like it's not taking a step in the right direction of having females being taken seriously in any form of, in any media form. That's my point.
You do realize that there are a lot of reasons why someone dresses the way they do, and even removing sexuality from it, how a person chooses to portray themselves usually is the source of part, or at least part, of their own self-confidence.
Okay.
And the way that I dress is how I feel attractive for myself.
Right.
Not for other people, but for myself. Because if I didn't feel attractive for myself, I would not have the confidence to put myself out there in the first place. Like, because if I feel good and someone says shitty comments, it bounces off me.
Right.
But if I don't feel good and someone's shitty, then it hurts more.
Right.
If that makes sense.
No, so. that makes a lot of sense, and that definitely does resonate, and I just wanted to follow up and say, like I said, if you're dressing because you feel cute and this is how you dress and this is what you like, I go for it. That's great. That's wonderful. You know why? Because your intentions are because you look good. You are not doing it because you are taking advantage of anybody or anything. You're doing it because you look good. And I'm not here to condemn you from that. At all.
I think that that's actually the case for a lot of women, though, on Twitch. I think to assume that someone's intentions are to take advantage are incredibly presumptuous. I mean, how on earth do you ever really know? Like, I mean, obviously, this is just talking about the way that someone dresses. If someone is being provocative outside of the clothing, like they're making a lot of sexual remarks or, like, movements, let's leave it at that. And obviously that's different, but I'm just talking about simply the way that someone dresses.
Okay, okay, so. I hear that, and I want to rebuttal with, like, you're right. There's no way for someone to automatically know if a girl is just looking cute or she's taking advantage of the system. But there are some telltale signs. And unfortunately, women can hide behind the concepts that many feminists do throw at us, slut-shaming, victim-blaming, to hide their crime. And now, let
me
explain.
Their crime of
The reason why I say that word is because if I go on your stream right now, I've never been, but if I go on your stream right now, can I ask you something in your description? Does it cost money for someone to email you?
No.
Do you have your Amazon wish list in your description?
No.
You don't? Okay, do you have special privileges for people that donate over a certain amount of money?
Not other than they get like I list their name.
Right, but you don't have like a special hangout time for them or anything, right? It's just if no. their names get listed on your screen, right?
Yeah.
And that's my point.
You are not
taking advantage of the women. Of the guys. You're not. And I think
even if I did all those things, I'm not entirely sure that that counts as taking advantage, because it's implying that these men don't have, their own willpower or, existence. It's like
exactly
saying that, like, what?
And I hear that. I know what you're saying. You're saying, like, the men are responsible for what they do. Like, if the men want to buy me an Amazon gift thing, if a girl has it on her stream, why is she the bad girl? You know, why is she the enemy, right? Is
yeah,
that kind of what you're saying?
I'm saying, like, you gotta consider that these guys, I mean, some of them might do it because it genuinely makes them happy that they're supporting someone that they like.
Right.
Like, I'm a cosplayer, and I get people who want to support me and do my stuff, too. So it's like, yeah. You know, a lot of people are genuinely fans for the most random of reasons, but it can bring them happiness. Like, I'm fans of really weird stuff, too, and I support. And I think everyone is a fan of something.
Sure.
And it's the idea that one thing is better than another when it comes to fandom, I disagree with. Like, if something brings you happiness, like, who gives a shit?
Yeah. No, I understand that. And I definitely, again, see where you're coming from. I just am trying to illuminate the idea that maybe some of these girls are taking advantage of the social ambiguity construct we have going on, which is exactly what you are defending. Which is, I can't, you know, openly say a girl is being, you know, is taking advantage of the system. Because she could easily turn around and tell me, no, I'm not. I just want to dress this way. I have no way. And that's why it's a dangerous topic. I have no way of proving it. Like, I have no way of proving either or. But I have clues. I have signs. Like, I have ways
I think you more just have judgments. Like, I just think you're making that as a really big judgment.
Okay. So you think that I'm being really judgmental?
Yep.
right. That's a yes, right?
Yeah.
and that's true. That's something that I struggle with. You know, growing up, my mom was very judgmental. I as well am very judgmental, which is why I'm trying to open-endedly, like, try to, you know, come to a conclusion that we can both walk away from, and at least maybe we won't agree with each other, but at least we'll be, like, a little more satisfied. Okay? So what I'm trying to get across to you is, I feel like the girls that dress provocatively, the girls that have their Amazon wish list out, the girls that, you know, have donation things or have boyfriend applications that cost money, just all of these things, I don't see the benevolence in this at all. And I think it gives a bad name to other female streamers who don't do those things. Because, you know, at the end of the day, those are also the girls that get the views. Like, they are the ones that, reach the front page because they are the controversial ones. You have the horny people, you have the people angry at them, and then you have the white knights. And that's why they get all of those views, but I just don't think that is a healthy environment. It's conducive to no positive end. Imagine all the guys calling them sluts in their stream chat. They just let that happen. They just allow that to happen.
I don't, and most women I know have very good moderators that stop that from happening too, so I'm not entirely sure. I mean, aside from Kaceytron, that's part of her troll kind of cohesiveness. Most women I know that stream, and I do know a lot because I host predominantly women when I stream after.
Right,
they have people to deal with that kind of stuff. They don't, like, encourage that it exists.
Sorry, I'm sick.
That's okay.
But like, one part of the video that I was trying to make is one of my best friends, her name is Leah, and her voice is very high-pitched. It just is. That's how she is. That's her life. Back when I was in high school, you know, this Asian craze where everybody wanted to be an anime girl and people would make their voices go up and squeak was cute for a lot of people, and I found it, you know, obnoxious. Now, the reason why I bring that up is because I'm gonna kill this nigga! Sorry, okay. The reason why I bring this up is because now the girls that fake the voices are making it impossible for Leah to get any legitimate, like, claim to her voice because people think that she's just making it up. And you don't think that's detrimental?
I think that I don't really know many women that do that. I'm sure there are because that seems like a weird thing some people would do, but I don't really know what to comment. I think if you're going to get hurt by something like that, you should probably not spend any time on the internet because that's such a silly thing to get upset about.
No, but see, that's just it. It's not a silly thing. Every single time these people are in videos, Lily Pichu, Natsumi, Aaliyah, they get called these horrible names. You should kill yourself. You're annoying. You're dumb. You're ugly. You're stupid. And that's not their fault. That's the fault of
men. Well, no, but harassment is not okay by anyone. And we should be encouraging the people within the community to treat each other better instead of picking each other apart for what we wear or what we sound like.
Right.
We should be encouraging better behavior, not tearing each other down.
Yes, yes. I agree with that so much. But I also believe that by saying women are blameless isn't fair. Because both parties are to blame. The horny men that say these fucked up things, or sorry, the men that say, and women that say these fucked up things, that's definitely, that's bad. That's wrong, and they should be reprimanded absolutely. Okay?
Okay, so I want to say something. What I wear on stream is never any different from anything that I've ever worn in real life. And I've worn even skimpier cosplays, for example. We both know that harassment in real life is bad. But for some reason, when we're online, that makes us partially responsible. Like, where does that come in? Just because we put the internet here, suddenly it's our fault.
Oh, okay. I see what you're saying. Yes, you're right. You wear the same stuff as you do in real life, but now that you're doing it on the internet, suddenly it's like, now it's an issue and it's your fault, and I get that, okay? And let me tell you why. Because in real life, you are not performing. You don't owe anyone anything, okay? If everyone had a camera on them 24/7 and it was projected to the internet, then maybe I'd understand, but we don't live in that world. You turn on your stream and you now have an audience, okay? You have an audience of people that are watching you. You choose to wear what you choose to wear, right? But now because you have an audience, you have to remember that what you do and or what you wear has an effect. No matter what. Like, what I wear has an effect. If I go on butt naked, I'm never gonna get a boyfriend. You know what I mean? Like, I have to keep the image up that I'm losing weight by only showing the upper half of my body. But when people see my giant ass, it's over. And that's the point. you have to be able to maintain an image. And when you breach that, when you start, like, dressing provocatively, which is fine, again, as long as your intent is okay. See, you don't do it. You don't do it for the money. At least I'd like to believe that, right? Like, I don't know you at all. But I'd like to assume that you don't.
I'm not even sure that a lot of women do. I think that every woman like streams probably has their own reasons for the way that they want to behave and dress.
Oh my god, like, you got money.
But yeah. I think that's something we're gonna have to probably disagree on.
Yeah, I mean,
but,
I
don't think that just because you put it online, that suddenly means that harassment in any regard is okay. Because right. It's scapegoating. It's like making it like so they can kind of justify the way that they behave because all the women they dress like this.
Whoa, dude! A subscriber. Okay. What, gay?
Okay, so
like,
you
being
think
a performer,
that...
I don't understand why that means that it's okay. Like I don't understand.
No, it's never okay. It's never okay. Saying bad, terrible, mean, awful things is never okay. I'm not gonna condone that at all. All I'm trying to say is that when you have the intent of milking horny nerds for their money, that is bad. That is all
I think
I'm...
that every, you know what? Every person who does Twitch wants to do well on Twitch.
Yes.
So, within that respect, yes, maybe some women, they think the more attractive I make myself, the better I will do.
Yes.
But that's literally every person on Twitch wants to do well, or they wouldn't even bother doing it. So it's kind of, and being more attractive in general makes you succeed at everything. So it's not even just a Twitch thing. Like, you know, that's life.
True.
And it sucks, but there you go.
True. You are absolutely right. However, if being hotter does get you a lot of things, trust me, I have very hot friends, and you would not believe the amount of messages they get on their gay apps while I'm struggling to get one a month, okay? So, trust me, I say, being hotter does make things easier. If you're hot and you want to flaunt it, then flaunt it. That's okay. That's a confidence issue. But I'm not attacking that at all. I'm saying if your intent is that you're hot and you want to use it to elicit money out of somebody, that's bad. I don't think that's good. I don't think that's cool. You're taking advantage of horny 12-year-old
virgins.
Well,
taking advantage of people is never good, but I would never criticize a whole mass of people I don't know or their intentions because I don't know what they are.
But
so
that's the thing. I didn't criticize... the video didn't criticize a mass of people. If you remember...
Like any women that dress in a way that you dislike, it seems to be, or use a weird voice.
Or, well, remember what I said. The video, or the streamers who have the gameplay about the game, and not about themselves being super hot, this isn't to you. It's the one with, like, pussy cam, tit cam, eye cam. I've seen that.
Never seen a pussy cam in my life. I mean, if you're saying they exist, fair enough, but...
I mean, I've definitely seen a camera of, like, a girl playing a game with a controller. She got a camera right there, but it's clearly on her tits, and then the other camera is like... Hold on, Rek'Sai's ganking, fuck. Oh, nigga, you really thought... You really thought, bruh, bye, hello? Hold on, I gotta do my TSM chant. Thank you. He really thought he was gonna kill me. This Rek'Sai got brave because he saw Santorin play Rek'Sai. Dumbass. Okay, so, I guess I'm trying to not say that women can't dress a certain way. That's not what I want to convey at all. I just want to convey that taking advantage of anything in any stretch is bad. Manipulating and taking advantage of people is never good. Guys or girls alike. It just so happens that there are a few streamers that do this. But it also so happens that those few streamers are the ones that get the views. Are the ones that I feel set a precedent for female streamers in some regard. And that's what my video was just trying to say. Now again, I could be very ignorant, stupid. I could be completely batshit wrong. I could be. And I'm open to that. I want to learn. This conversation is happening because of that. I'm not arrogantly asserting that I'm right. There's no right answer here. There's just a bunch of people that want to discuss this, and that's all I'm trying to do.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to have you know that I'm not here to say anything definitive. I just put my opinion out there, you know?
Well, I think that if you do genuinely wish to help women on Twitch, then the way you should be going about it is to encourage just people to be nicer to each other, because that is predominantly the problem. You're never going to be able to stop if there are, as you think, women that manipulate based on how provocative they are to get Amazon wish lists or whatever, because it's not something you can prove. But if you want the experience for your friends and for other women to be better on Twitch, it should be to encourage others to treat them better, because it's not just the thirsty, like, boys.
Whoa, that, dude, they don't a bother subscriber? Me at all. What
it's the
gay?
Ones that are vile and making rape comments, or, you know, it's and you know what makes me feel worse is when people come in and try to be judgmental towards me, and as if I'm doing something wrong when I'm not. You know, right. That probably sucks more than anything else.
Right.
Yeah.
No, you're right. I that's the thing, is that for me, in this discussion,
oh my God,
there is no
money.
Right answer. Like, you are making valid points, you're making sense, I get it. But I hope that you also see where I'm coming from, to where when I see a girl... you know, have their Amazon wish list, use, like, manipulate guys, email them, be cutesy because they know that they've got money. To me, that just kind of, you know, it makes me kind of sad. Like, and I don't think that's good. That just kind of sucks. And
yeah, but there's nothing you can do about that. Like, and it removes the focus from something you could change, which is the general, I mean, have you ever watched the LCS and the stuff that shocks gets said at her? Like, that's the kind of people, and there's all these kids are watching each other say these same things, and then yes. They perpetuate the same comments because yes. they're dumb and they just copy each other.
But you have to remember that our audience in League of Legends are our children, and they're horny, and they don't know how to treat women for various reasons. I'm not excusing their behavior. I'm just trying to say they don't know how to treat women.
Social change doesn't happen until you can consider the fact that it can happen. I mean, yes, there are 12-year-olds, but 12-year-olds can still learn how to behave. Like, I have 3 younger brothers, and one of them especially was the stereotypical one who would shout, you know, down Xbox Live, the most vile things ever.
Right.
And it was pretty easy to fix. I just took his Xbox away and then said, if you behave like that and say those things again, you ain't ever gonna get it back. And he stopped. So it's like, excusing them for being kids is, no, they're 12, but not like 2. They know how to learn. And
no, but listen to what you just said. You sound like an amazing sister, and not everyone is as privileged to have someone care.
But you have a huge platform. You can make this change start to happen. But streamers like you are the ones that need to be standing up and making this happen.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry, I'm getting emotional about it.
No. It's totally fine. And that, I hope that I'm not upsetting you. I'm just...
No, it's not that. Okay, it's something I feel really strongly about.
I understand. A lot of people do. And again, I am not here to say that you're wrong or bad or anything. All I'm trying to say is you're right. You know, people like me need to make that change. But I'd be remiss if I didn't say that the girls in question are not just completely innocent. Because some of them know what they're doing. Some of them know exactly what they're doing. They know exactly.
But does that really matter as much in the grand scheme of things? Like, if your primary focus is to make things better for women and for your friends, then it should be trying to make positive change rather than just criticizing a pretty small minority of people that aren't ever gonna go away.
Okay, hold on. When you say pretty small minority, what do you mean by that? Do you mean like there aren't many girl streamers?
No, you said it was the minority of female streamers. I'm sure you don't mean it's majority.
Right. No, it is a minority. I know so many female streamers that are just dope, you know? I know that. But, God, kill this Janet. Kill this bitch. Hold on. Ah! Sorry, please bear with me.
I'm watching a stream at the moment. It's okay.
Okay. Yes, it's up to people like us to make the change, which is why I have feverishly said on my stream that the guys who feed into this and say all these fucked up things, they are definitely at fault. 110%.
Oh my God.
It is not just the women. However, in my head, the way I think about it, somebody put this to me quite cleanly. They said, all right, you know, who's at fault? The drug dealer or the addict? And to me, both are. And that's how that's genuinely how I feel. And I'm sorry if you don't agree with that, but I just feel like in some respects, the women that are doing this now, again, they are the minority. You're right. The absolute minority here.
But who is at fault really shouldn't matter so much as what can you change you can do to make things better. Like, mm-hmm. trying to point fingers at some women that are being manipulative or trying to do... Like, there's nothing you can do about it, man. If these women exist, there's no way to prove it. Like...
No, but see, that's the kind of thinking... That's dangerous thinking. If we're just going to be like, well, there's nothing we can do about it, then, like... Why even care about anything?
Because you can make positive change in other ways. You can't make change here, but there's so much more that you could do that would be so much better.
Well, I'd argue that I've already made a change. I'm not going to say that it's not like, that it's, you know, I am the Messiah and the change
Pretty
is mine.
Sure all those women that you're thinking about are going to continue doing exactly what they've been doing. It's not going to make any difference in that regard. You've just made a lot of more people more likely to go harass them. That's about it.
But at the very least, at least the discussion has started. Like, I haven't seen this discussion actually in ever. Like, and I'm
No, I've seen people can be really salty about certain female streamers pretty much since I started streaming, like, consistently.
What I'm saying is I haven't seen the discussion. Like, I just haven't, and I'm really active on streams. I mean, Kaceytron, sure, but I mean, she, you know Kaceytron, so you know.
Yeah,
what
it's a troll act. It doesn't bother me.
And I don't want you to think that, like, you know, I am the starter of the conversation. I am God. Like, no, I'm just saying that the conversation was once again brought to light, and I'm glad that we're having it.
Oh my God! You got money.
I really want you to. Oh, sorry.
I guess they didn't have any vision.
People are donating. I had to read it. I just want you to know that I feel like it's more than just... I feel like it's important to talk about where the blame is, honestly. I think that that's trying to find the root of the issue and fixing it there instead of just blaming guys for being stupid. But
I mean, you should see some of the things people are saying in your chat about me right now. Like, she is a slut and she's just trying to convert.
You got money.
Like,
hey, but like, what about me? When I go into other people's... thing. Everyone says, oh, all he does is talk about black, fat, and gay, and then I get death threats, people calling me faggot, nigger, like, I get it too. Everybody gets it. When you go online,
I know, but you are a spot. Like, when people are shitty in my stream, whether that's to me or general other people, I call them out on it, and it has made my stream so much better, because I don't put up with shit. Like, it does mean I have to have people timed out quite a lot, but it works. But if you just ignore the way that your audience behaves, then they tend to get pretty toxic.
Okay, well, people are gonna say what they're gonna say.
Like,
you know,
they're just, yeah.
People are gonna, and you know what, I do know that that's not, it's not good. I mean, I have a rule where my chat should never be subscribers mode only, and I know the you know, the consequences of that. It's, you know, you get those people that come in, say mean mm-hmm. things to me, mean things about me, and I would say blah, 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 have, like, tougher skin, but we both know that
oh, I have incredibly tough skin. I was bullied all through high school, so I'm not bothered by anything, but I'm just saying, to make things better, we all have to be responsible for at least encouraging change within our own audience, because that's about all we can do.
Right. So.
I think that Twitch can change for the better. It's just gonna take all of us to, you know, make it actually happen.
Whoa, dude! A so subscriber? Then I don't understand why you don't believe that women are at fault at all. That's what I don't
know. Well, you're saying some women you think are manipulative, yes. And it's a minority, yes. Well, but we both
Whoa,
know there's
dude,
nothing we
a
can
subscriber?
Really do about
what
it. Is
but that
it's hard to prove.
Right, like, but does that make it correct?
I guess not, but like, I don't know who these women are, you know, it's, or who you think they are, or, like, what can we do about it? Nothing, but we can make Twitch better.
No, but see, that's what I'm talking about. Like, you have that idea. You feel like you can't do anything about it. That's not the right way to think about this. What can we do about it?
You'd have to be able to prove it for a start. None of us can, so...
But, like, there are just some things... Like, I know this is going to sound bad, and this is really going to be, like, a really bad argumentative point that I'm going to make, but when you see the signs, it's not that hard to just straight up say what somebody is doing. Like, the popular streamers that I'm talking about, they understand what they're doing. They're not dumb, and I'm not going to out them, but, for example, did you read the tweet that that girl sent me after she asked me to take my video down?
I did not know.
Can I read it for you?
Yes, sure.
Okay, one second. This is what she said to me, okay? Mm-hmm. She messaged me. She asked me, can you take my picture from your video down? I thought she was trolling because, as we know, you can't just take an individual picture down from a video. To which I said, no, I'm not going to do that, and I can't do that, really, because that's not how videos work, you know? And she responded with, like, pretty much, whatever, because I still make tons of donations at the end of the day. And you're still one of the fat creeps who come on their screens to my photos. No wonder your friend killed himself. I would, too, if I had friends like you.
Well, she sounds like a pretty vile person, but that's her just being ridiculously gross and defensive because she obviously didn't like to be singled out. And I have to say, I don't agree in singling out people because that's...
But I didn't. I didn't tell anyone her name.
You put a picture of her in your video.
Yeah.
That's singling out, my friend. I'm sorry.
Well, okay. You know what? I'll give that to you. That's fine. What I did there wasn't right. I felt like if she's going to share her picture with 75,000 other people in a Facebook group, then... Yeah, like, I figure that the...
Yeah, but you have to be responsible for the fact you have a huge following.
Oh, I'm aware.
Go attack her.
I am not. No, but they don't know who she is. That's the point.
It's not that hard to figure that stuff out if you want.
I didn't know who she was. But I see what you're saying, and I'm going to agree with you. What I did there wasn't right. Sure. I'm not going to argue that. I would never argue that, ever. I'm not going to sit here and defend an immature action that I did. No. But
okay.
I am going to say... that it's clear that this girl knows exactly what she's doing to manipulate people to get donations. She's one of the people that I'm talking about.
Whoa, dude,
and
a subscriber?
It's clear that that exists. Knowing that that exists, you have to be able to at least concede to the idea that these women are not good for Twitch.
What can you do about it? Like,
Wait, but we're not on that yet. We're just at the point where we are saying that she is not good for Twitch. Can you admit that?
It doesn't sound like she's good for anything.
You are absolutely right.
That's how she genuinely behaves, but bad people exist everywhere, man. You can't get rid of them.
Right, and that I'm not making a video about just bad people. I'm making a video about my gaming community. That's where I am right now. So that's why, I mean, if I were just a general vlogger about life, then yeah, maybe I'd make a video like, people can be bad. But in this case, I was able to identify and eye out, like, the girl that I'm talking about. The kind of women that I'm talking about. And that was my focal point. Is people like her exist? And you know what? Before she wrote that to me, I had no idea that she would react like that. But she literally just admitted her harebrained scheme. And then... prove that women are out there manipulating viewers. Now, yes, the horny people are also at fault for feeding into this. If they don't want to support it, they shouldn't watch it. But I don't know about you, but a lot of us guys make stupid-ass choices when we're horny. Are we responsible for it? Absolutely. Which is why the blame is still on them. But I've seen too many times where my friends, my family, beautiful women come into play, and then all of a sudden... they're getting manipulated, they're buying them cars, they're buying them rings, they're buying them all this shit, and I think that's wrong. Manipulation in any sense is wrong. That girl doing that is wrong. And I just don't know how anybody can argue anything different. That's
I'm not saying manipulative people are wrong.
You got money.
You can't get rid of them. It's impossible.
Okay, but
we can do is encourage people on Twitch to not necessarily, you know, buy into it.
No, you can't get rid of them, but you can expose them. That's the point. You're a girl, this won't work as well. with my example, I was saying if you were my friend and this girl was, I'm gay, actually, it works. Let's say we were homies, right? We live close to each other, okay? And you were dating this guy, and he was hot, but he was manipulating you because you had money and he wanted popularity, fame, he wanted to buy you shit. I'm gonna tell you. I'm gonna be like, hey, yo, girl, this boy right here, he is trifling. He's using you for your Twitch fame.
What are you
getting? He's using you, girl. Now, if I told you all that and I showed you proof, would you still be with him?
Well, I see what you're getting at. And with the girl that tweeted you specifically, then I suppose it's fine to expose her, but you realize that's a one-off. Most women aren't going to admit to it, to get exposed in the first place. She obviously probably did that because she was angry.
And I've never told anyone her actual name. So, if she admits it herself, that's up to her. I'm not about witch hunts. I just did it.
To be honest, I don't know if she even said that just because she was riled up. The thing is, people can be ridiculous when they've been in a situation like that. I mean, I'm not defending her. Maybe she really is as awful as she said she is herself, but I've seen people saying really nasty things just because they're defensive.
But really quick, would you break up with that person if I showed you proof that they were using you and manipulating you for your things? For everything.
Yeah, sure, of course.
And that right there is what I'm talking about. That if we were able to confront this issue and show that girls like that exist.
We can't have a witch hunt. That would be horrible. You're saying if we can expose them, but how? Without, witch hunting and singling people out and potentially sending huge amounts of people to go bully each other. There is no way to do it. That will just end in bad things happening.
My goal here was not to take, Oh my god, please don't be doing
that. Oh my god, you got money.
Oh, okay, they're not doing bad. I'm gonna need you to just. Okay. Okay, again, guess what? You're not wrong. You're not wrong. How are we supposed to do it? We're not gonna be able to find them. I totally get that. All I'm trying to say is my method the best way? Probably not. But at least we're able to vividly see that at least one. At least there is one girl out there with all the symptoms that many other girls have that is being manipulative and just, I don't think that's right. And I feel like that's my only way of defending it. And now you're asking me, well, you should only be telling the guys that they're, you know, they should stop harassing them. You're right. They should stop. They should definitely stop. But also the girls like the one that I just talked about should stop doing her shit too. That's why it's a two-sided coin. There's not just one side to it.
As far as I see it, you can't stop people from being manipulative, and you cannot stop people from getting manipulated. The best we can do is just make Twitch in general a nicer place. We can't send people on witch hunts to root out. And you know what? For every one manipulative woman there is on Twitch, there's about 1,000 men that go around saying absolutely vile things, and I find it odd that that they're more the problem. When the vile guys outnumber the women by God knows how many.
Well, wait, and that's the fault of just interest. Women or men outnumber women in gaming, period.
Yes, of course, it's partly because, it's not completely because of that, but that doesn't mean that one, it just is more of an obvious problem because there's so many more of them, so.
Right. So, I'm kind of sad because, I don't want you to have the idea that we can't do anything about it because it's not true. I think that we can. I think that, like, now that we have clear symptoms and signs, if a girl wants to dress provocatively, she can. But does that mean that she needs to, like, put her, like, you know, I just feel like when a girl's putting her Amazon wish list, she's saying, buy this for me, buy that for me, oh, you're cute, you can email me for $5, like, we've seen that. My fans have seen that. I've talked about this before. People have it on their streams where you have to, like, pay for a boyfriend donation. These things are ridiculous. This is the kind of thing that I'm talking about, and it's just not healthy for Twitch. There are a lot of things that aren't healthy for Twitch. But by ignoring the fact that women can be, like, problematic in that sense, I think is just being ignorant to the fact that, you know,
that if exists. Twitch wants to make certain things not allowed on profiles, it's entirely up to them to sort that shit out. If they want to ban Amazon wishlists, for example, for being listed, they can, and maybe they should. And that is something maybe you should encourage if you want change in that regard. Get the rules changed and enforced harder.
But yes.
If Twitch do not do that, then they don't care about the community in the same way that you guys do, and you're gonna have to put up and shut up. Like,
absolutely.
You either do something or you don't, you know.
100,000,000% everything that you just said, beautiful. I agree. And I think that we should change the rules. I think the rules should be changed. I think Amazon wish lists should be gone. I think paid boyfriend applications should be gone. I think that's all horseshit. I think that, like, if there's a way to take all of that off, that'd be great. At the end of the day, it should be
start
tips.
A petition and get it going. I will sign it. I don't think Amazon wish lists need to be on there. I don't think that boyfriend applications need to be there. I think that external gifts or donations like Skype dates probably shouldn't be on there. Anything that is a date is not something I agree with, but I do not believe in condemning people for doing something that is not technically against the rules. When it's against the rules, condemn the shit out of them, but until then, they're just walking within a line because they can.
Right. Because they found something that is stupid that they can do legally, that doesn't make it okay. Just because they found a loophole doesn't make it okay.
No, but you can't, like... I can't judge someone who's not for breaking a rule if they're not actually breaking a rule.
But what
you
about what? What about
I
before?
I don't like it, but it's just, like that doesn't hold any weight. If you want things to change, you have.
Right, but what about when before the terms of service changed, when people could drink on stream and show like hella breasts? Now you can't. Why? Because people had a voice. Like, it was stupid. People were like, okay, this is happening when he's drunk on stream. There were a lot of reasons. I don't know all of them. But I could say that I think raising voices is an appropriate, like... One second. I am in a team fight. Yes. Okay, and we are losing this team fight. Flash. Oh my god. I died. Rip. Anyway, I think that you're right. The right thing to do here is to, you know, try to make the rules so that women just can't get away with that. But you understand that they're still manipulating that broken rule set. They're still using it to their advantage, and some of them who are using it strictly for malevolent purposes, I feel, shouldn't be, like, witch-hunted, but they definitely, they're not innocent. That's just how I feel.
I understand. At the end of the day, I know quite a few people that have been streaming so much longer than me that are incredibly protective of Twitch because, you know, it's something they're very fond of and community that they're part of. But it gets to the point where I feel like some people are a bit too overprotective of it, and it's not always in the best ways.
Okay.
Like, I can sympathize, but I think there are positive ways to deal with what you dislike, and there are negative ways, and I feel like what you did was negative when it could have been way more positive than it was.
Okay. I think that we've got it. We've got some sort of agreement. I think that we can agree that those things should be against the rules. It's kind of a bullshit thing to do, and while it's not okay to witch hunt them, it's still not a good thing that those girls, whoever is doing it, are doing, right?
Yeah, but it's just, there's nothing you can do when you cannot prove something or if they're not breaking a rule. It's,
okay. Okay, yeah. And that's a separate issue entirely of what we can do, but as long as we know that the girls doing that, that as long as we're at on the same page that the specific individuals manipulating the system like that are not good, I think that we're both on the same page, honestly.
Yeah, I just can't say I personally know any of those kind of right. women. Maybe they exist. I've just not met one. I'll take your word for it. I don't okay. mind. But it's, the thing is, there's going to be so many women like me or similar, you know, that dress in cosplay sometimes or whatever. They're going to get hit by all of the negative criticism just because they might seem exactly the same as all the really manipulative women, because people judge based on appearance. And they right. don't differentiate. And so, that's the problem, man. It's like, I get all of this shit, and I'm not even doing anything wrong, you know?
Yeah, okay. No, I see and understand that, but I think that, I think we're good. I think this conversation was really good, and I'm really glad that you came on and talked about it. So hopefully you don't fucking hate me, but,
No, I don't. I'm just amused by your chat saying, can she shut the fuck up?
No, I'm not. I decided not to read the chat for... But all right, I'm gonna get to this game, and if we want to talk later on, maybe after my stream, we can revisit this. But I think that we've beaten it to death, and even though we don't completely agree, we came to one conclusion, and that's what I wanted.
No worries. I just hope that you're gonna do something more positive in the future. With like, I understand being passionate about something. Like, that's fine. I just think there are more, not just positive, but more constructive ways to, you know, get things
okay.
done.
Yeah, I'll concede to that. Like, maybe there was a better constructive way to do it. My method may not have been the best. I felt like it was a method, and I felt like it sparked a conversation that's being really healthy around the entire community. So,
sure.
Either or, like, yeah, I definitely see that. So I'll talk to you later, okay?
Okay. Bye.
All right, I'll see you.